Now, the next thing we're going to be doing is the nose. Now, I'm using the light grey for the light areas. A spot there, and then the 233 for the darker. Now, where you've got an area like that where you have some light against it, you've got no problem. But it's in areas like this where you have a dark area. So what I would do in a situation like that is use then the dark 181 to reinstate that. It's going to go right up there, but we don't want to worry about that at the moment. It's where you have the separation. Let's just also do that too, because that's going to have to be darker than that. It's just a smidgen of light on that side. All right, now let's carry on with that. Very peculiar nose, I've got to say. I haven't had anything quite like this. I've done a couple of monkeys, a chimp, the orangutan. But this is very delicate. Now here we've got some dark, but it's only up to there. And here, spins around like that. Now before I put this colour on there, we're going to put just a tiny bit of the 169 on there. I don't want too much of this. You know already it spreads like wildfire. So we just want a touch of it in there. And also in here, although it's not going to show up. It's still a nice idea to put it in. Good. Now there's another little area. It's not really too bad. It's just here where we have the mouth coming round like that. And then we have again the 233 in here. And then we've got a tongue there. It's going to be very light. And just a little bit there. Okay, now we've got it all sorted. We can now just use the stronger colours, which is 181. Noses particularly always look very awkward until you put the final touches on, and this is no exception. It'll probably look a little better once I've got this dark in. I'm being very tentative. And I would suggest you do the same. Don't rush at this. There's some peculiar little twists and turns, as you can see in there. Now I'm going to do one section at a time and fill it in. And I'm going to blend it. That's okay, that's good. Now, same problem occurs here. Now, I'm going to put the black in there, and that will give us that separation. course, just underneath. Come back in with the 181. Now there was just a touch of light there, if you remember, I put in. The dark colours I'm not registering there, which is exactly what I'm looking for, because I can reinstate that. So let's carry on. This is awkward because I'm going to have to put the 181 here just to give myself a separation there. Once again, use the black. Alright, now, wrong colour. Let's just see this side, it's the same on the other side. It's just a little slight detail there, comes out. Now I'm going to have to weaken that quite a bit. That colour and that colour is the same, but we can't have it the same. I'm going to have to work on that. Using the colour shaper, what we're going to do here before we put the black on is also put some of this in here. Most peculiar. I'm not explaining what I'm doing because I really don't know. So you'll just have to follow what I'm trying to achieve here, folks. It's a little bit making up as you go along job. But I'm pulling it off. A little bit of light, and I'm going to use white for this, just on this tip there and there, and it stretches up there, like that. And over here, using the white again because it's quite light, and I'm hoping that I can force the white or the light into the nose on this side, creating just the implication, suggestion of dark there. Well, I think I pulled it off. Now that comes around there like that, and then into here. Yeah, we've still got the black to put on here yet. But I wanted to bring the white in. No, I've worked that really well. Pleased with that. There's a little bit more here, which I can use a little bit of white on. You see how it's beginning to work now? Right, now we've got to put the black on those. So start with this. Although there is a separation in there, you're not going to see it. And I think the thing is, when you have a picture that you're copying like this, with no obvious areas, distinct areas, you've just got to follow what you see. But it's a good idea to have, as I did have, the other pictures that I got from the internet which showed the nose, so I was aware of it, even though it wasn't obvious on this picture. Now I'm going to use a little bit of black just to, you'll see what I'm trying to do in a minute, coming back in with the other colours. It's the grey I think I'll use at the moment. I've got that white in there, but really I've got to almost interfere with that. You're going to have a problem here. And you see me fiddling about. Trying to get the feel of this. There's also some more of that colour I've noticed. So let's put a bit of that in. And we'll use the 181 just to put what I'm hoping for is I'm going to use the white in a minute. That's going to have to be darkened a little. But I think what I'll do with that is I'll use some. In fact, I'm going to move over to the ivory colour shaper now, folks. It's a little softer. Hoping I can do is represent that area just a little better. Yep, that's not bad. And here as well. There are nostrils as well, and they are there, but there's no way we're going to be able to see them. Just blend this again so we have a nice smooth effect. Now, you've seen me do this before, but I'm sure you don't mind seeing again. We can just drag some of that colour into shading over here. Because what we've got at the moment is a distinct line, and really I don't want one. If you turn it over, you can then go on the other side of it. You back again. show you where the nostrils are on here. There, there, and they're there. And like I say, you're not going to see them. Well, I say that, I think I can actually see them now. Well, maybe I've surprised myself, but that's where they are. With just a hint of, I think I will push a bit up now. Now we're going to put some white in, so white on the tip there, and then graduate it. Because that division runs, it doesn't run all the way up the nose, it just runs to about there. That's a nice idea to put that in. Clean the point off and do the other side. Now, I think that is about the best we're going to do. I really am pleased with that. I hope you enjoyed that.